Today we're going to do that pre-trip on that Class A automatic. First thing we're going to do, when you guys get into the DMV, you guys are going to chuck the wheels. Chuck the wheels means you're going to put one chuck on the front and one chuck on the back. That prepares the truck for the air brakes and for everything, the test that you guys are going to perform in the DMV. First thing we're going to do is a pre-trip. A pre-trip. You guys are going to put yourself in the front of the truck, and then you're going to start with the clearance lights. My clearance lights, they're not cracked or broken, they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. They're amber in color because they face in the front of the vehicle. Now I'm going to inspect my windshield. I want to make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted and not excessively pitting. It's securely mounted by the rubber seal. My rubber seal is not excessively worn or torn and it will not leak to the inside. My windshield wipers are securely attached to the arm. The arm securely attached to the vehicle, no missing hardware. My windshield wiper blade is not excessively worn or torn and it's a full contact to the vehicle. Now, I'm going to inspect my headlight covers. I have one here and one on the other side. My headlight covers, I'm gonna make sure they're not cracked or broken and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. The light right here and the light right here, it represents my low beam and my high beam. I'm gonna make sure they're not cracked or broken and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. The amber light on the side and this amber light on this side, the function of this light is that my left turn signal, my right turn signal, my forward flashers and my running lights. They're not cracked or broken, securely mounted, no missing hardware. I'm gonna look my vehicle and I'm gonna make sure it's not leaning to either side, indicating the suspension problem. It can be flat tire, leaf spring failure, or that my load is shifting. I'm gonna look under my vehicle. I'm gonna make sure it's no paddles, they indicating that any type of fluid is leaking. I'm gonna look and make sure it's no hanging hose and hanging wires. From there, I'm gonna open my hood. I'm gonna use 3 points of contact. I'm gonna grab it from here. I'm gonna put my foot right here. And then I'm gonna open it. I'm gonna start from this side. First thing I'm gonna speak on this side is my alternator. My alternator is not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. The wires for my alternator, I'm gonna make sure they're properly routed, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, securely mounted, no missing hardware. Now I'm gonna inspect my water pump. My water pump, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. My water pump and my alternator, they're belt driven. The belt, I'm gonna make sure it's not excessively worn or torn, and it's a full contact to the vehicle. If I pull on it, it should be no more than 3/4 of the play. Now, I'm gonna inspect all the hoses on this side of the vehicle. I'm gonna make sure it's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. I'm gonna inspect all the wires on this side of the vehicle. I'm gonna make sure they're properly routed, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, securely mounted, no missing hardware. Now I'm gonna inspect the other side. Now on this side of the vehicle, first thing I'm gonna inspect is my coolant reservoir. My coolant reservoir is not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware, and it's on the proper level. The cap for my coolant reservoir is on the lock position. It's not cracked or broken or leaking, and the rubber seal inside is not excessively worn or torn, and it will not leak. From my coolant reservoir, I'm gonna spread my oil dipstick. My oil dipstick, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. If I need to check the level, I will pull it out, wipe it in, reinsert it, check the level of my oil. If I need to add it oil, I will add it through the cap by the gallon. This one right here is my transmission dipstick. My transmission dipstick is not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. If I need to add a fluid on my transmission, I will add it through here. Now, I'm gonna inspect right here, is my air compressor. My air compressor, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. under my air compressor is going to be my power steering pump. My power steering pump, I'm going to make sure it's no crack, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted. My air compressor and my power steering pump, they're gear driven. From there, I'm going to inspect all the hoses on this side of the vehicle. I'm going to make sure it's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. I'm going to inspect all the wires on this side of the vehicle. I'm going to make sure they're properly routed, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, securely mounted, no missing hardware. From there, I'm going to inspect my steering column or steering shaft. I'm going to make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. It's securely mounted by two U-joints. I have one here and one in the top. My U-joints, I'm going to make sure they're not cracked or broken and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. If I pull on it, it should be no more than 10 degrees of play. From here, I'm going to inspect my steering box. My steering box, I'm going to make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. For my steering box, I'm going to inspect my power steering reservoir. My power steering reservoir, I'm going to make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. It's on the proper level. If I need to add a fluid, I will add it to the cap. The cap is on the tight position. It's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted. The rubber seal inside is not excessively worn or torn, and it will not leak. Now I'm going to inspect my power steering hose. My power steering hose, I'm going to make sure it's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. From there, I'm going to inspect the frame on this side of the vehicle. The frame on this side of the vehicle, I'm going to make sure it's not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. Doesn't have any legal holes or legal welds. From my frame, I want to inspect my leaf spring hangers. I have one in here and I have one in the back. My leaf spring hangers, I want to make sure they're not cracked or broken and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. Right in here is my leaf spring bushing. My leaf spring bushing, I want to make sure it's not excessively worn or torn and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. Now I'm going to inspect my leaf springs. My leaf springs, I want to make sure it's not cracked or broken or shifting and they're securely mounted. No missing hardware. They're securely mounted by two U-bolts, the shim, the spacers, and four nuts on the bottom. They're not cracked or broken, securely mounted, no missing hardware. For my leaf springs, I'm going to inspect my shock absorber and my shock absorber mounts. I'm going to make sure they're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware, and my shock absorber is not leaking. From there, I want to inspect my windshield washer reservoir. My windshield washer reservoir, I want to make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. The cap is on the lock position, it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, and the rubber seal inside is not excessively worn or torn, and it will not leak. I want to mention that my windshield washer reservoir is on the proper level. Now I want to inspect my pitman arm, my drag link, my upper control arm, my lower control arm, and my tie rod. I'm gonna make sure they're not cracked or broken and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. They're not damaged. They're securely mounted by three castle nuts and three cutter pins. I have one in here, and one under. Now, I'm gonna inspect my air brake hose. My air brake hose, I'm gonna make sure it's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. This one right here is my brake chamber and my brake chamber clamp. I want to make sure they're not cracked or broken and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware, and they're not leaking. This one right here is my ABS wire. My ABS wire, I'm going to make sure it's no abrasions, no exposed wire, no frayed wire, properly routed, securely mounted, no missing hardware. Right in front of my brake chamber is going to be my push rod and my slack adjuster. My push rod and my slack adjuster, I'm going to make sure they're not cracked or broken. They're securely mounted. They're securely mounted by two pins and two cutter pins. They're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted. If I pull on it, it should be no more than 1 inch of the play when my brakes are released. Now, I want to start inspecting my wheel. For my wheel, first thing I want to inspect is my inside hub seal and my outside hub seal. I want to make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. Is my hub seal was leaking, I will see puddle or a spin trail. If it was, as I need to add it fluid, I will add it through the cap. The cap is on the tight position, it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted. From my hub seal, I want to start inspecting my brake liners. My brake liners, I want to make sure they're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. They're not allowed to have less than 1/4 inch of the thinnest point. This one right here is my brake drum. My brake drum is not cracked or broken and is securely mounted. Doesn't have any sign of the coloration indicating the overheating problem. Between my brake liners and my brake drum, they're free of debris, grease, or any other contamination. Now I'm going to inspect my rim. This is my inside rim and my outside rim. I'm going to make sure they're not cracked or broken and they're securely mounted. Doesn't have any legal holes or legal welds. My rim and my brake drum, they're securely mounted by the lug nuts. All my lug nuts, they're present, they're on the tight position. They're not cracked or broken or have any distortion. It's when my lug nuts was loose, I will see rusty in this metal rim. Now I want to inspect my tire. I want to inspect the inside tire, the outside tire, and the face of my tire. I want to make sure there's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and that's properly seated to my rim. To be specific, this is a steering tire. It's not allowed to be regrouped, recap, or retread. And it's not allowed to have less than 4/32 of the deepest point. This tire and the tire on the other side could not be mixed match. It has to be same type of tread and same size. The air specification of my tire is 110 PSI or manufacturer specification. To check the air on my tire, I will do it to the valve stem by the tire gauge. My valve stem, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked, broken, or leaking, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. And then, I don't see a cap, so I don't wanna mention the cap. From here, I'm gonna start thinking, is I missing something on my April trip? If I don't missing nothing, I will say it, I will inspect the other side of the vehicle, the same way I inspect this side of the vehicle. Now I'm gonna start inspecting my couplings. This is how you guys are gonna inspect the couplings and the automatic truck for the Class A. First thing I'm gonna inspect is gonna be my emergency line and my service line. I'm gonna make sure there's no abrasions, bulges, cuts, or leaks, and they're securely mounted. They're securely mounted to my tractor, and they're securely mounted to my trailer. They're securely mounted to my trailer with the glad hands and the glad hand receivers. I want to make sure my glad hand and my glad hand receivers, they're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. The rubber seal in my between my glad hand and my glad hand receivers is not excessively worn or torn, and it will not leak. And then, when you guys say it's securely mounted to my tractor, make sure they're not cracked or broken, and they're securely mounted, no missing hardware. Now I'm going to inspect my electrical cord. My electrical cord is securely mounted to my tractor, and it's no exposed wire, no frayed wire, properly routed, and securely mounted. And it's securely mounted to my trailer on the junction box. Okay? Because there's no exposed wire, no frayed wire, and it's properly routed, I'm going to make sure it's not electrical tape or black tape. I'm going to mention that my two hoses and my electrical cord is a proper distance on the cat wall. Now, I'm going to inspect the apron of my trailer. The apron of my trailer, I'm going to make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. This one is welded, so I'm going to inspect the welds, make sure it's not cracked, welded, or miswelded. This one right here is my fifth wheel. My fifth wheel, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. I'm gonna mention that between my apron and my fifth wheel is not daylight and it's properly greased. From here, I'm gonna inspect my fifth wheel lever. I'm gonna make sure it's on the lock position, it's not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. My fifth wheel is securely mounted to my platform by the pin and cutter pin. My platform is securely mounted to the frame. I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. My frame on my platform is securely mounted to the frame of the vehicle. I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware. From here, I'm gonna walk into the back and I'm gonna go under the vehicle. Now right in here is my kingpin. My kingpin, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken and it's securely mounted. This one is welded, so I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked, welded, no miswelding.
and it's on the lock position by the locking jaw. My locking jaw, I'm gonna make sure it's not cracked or broken, and it's securely mounted, no missing hardware, and it's on the lock position around the shank of the kingpin. With that, you guys gonna come in back, exit the trailer, and then you guys gonna mention between my landing gear and my vehicle is the proper distance to perform a 90 degree turn. That completes my couplings.